Good morning, students. In today's class of hotel management, we start with a new topic, that is franchising. In the previous classes, we have studied the various retail formats. We have seen that the retail formats can be divided under three heads: store-based, non-store-based, service-based. Under store-based, again the formats will be divided as per the ownership and as per the merchandise that is sold. Accordingly, non-store based also there are certain retail formats which are based on non-store basis, and then also we can divide the retail format based on the services it offers. So in this way we can divide the retail formats. We have also understood the various emerging retail formats that are available in India, emerging retail formats that are going to develop further in future in India. So in today's topic will be franchising. The franchising, we have already covered this topic under store-based retail format, under ownership-based. We have completed the topic. But sometimes question may come in retail format. When the question, long question for your examination will come, they may ask, write retail formats which are generally store-based, write non-store-based retail formats, write service-based retail formats, or write what are the various emerging retail formats in India. So these are the ways questions are set up. Apart in this way, different questions will be asked. If question comes for write the retail formats based on store, then you will again write ownership based or merchandise based. If the question comes only for ownership based or merchandise based, similarly the answer will be attended. If it is question comes for non-store based retailing, you will write only non-store based retailing headings, formats that we have discussed. Similarly, for service based, if the question comes only service based questions will be, retail formats will be answered. And when comes to the emerging formats, you will write the emerging format that are available in India. But sometimes, apart from all these retail formats headings, there is one question that may come separately, that is franchising. Franchising, even though it is part of the store-based retail formats, it sometimes come as a altogether separate question, where the question will be coming, what is franchising, what are the various characteristics of franchising, or what is franchising, what are the various characteristics and types of franchising, what is franchising, or what are the various benefits and advantages and disadvantages of franchising. So we'll be discussing the franchising topic in detail. It may come as a separate question for your examination. So from examination point of view, we understand franchising in a more detailed format. Other topics, there is no more required to go in detail. According to the headings, they will come store-based, non-store-based, service-based, or emerging formats. But franchising may independently come as a long question. So we'll understand that. So what is franchising? Franchising has been defined by David D. Setz. He says that a franchise is a form of business ownership created by contract whereby a company grants a buyer the rights to engage in selling or distributing its products or services under a prescribed business format in exchange for royalties or share of profits. The buyer is called as the franchisee, and the company that sells the rights to its business concept is called as the franchisor. So in order to understand the definition, we will divide the definition into small parts. The first part will be, a franchise is a form of business ownership created by a contract. So there are two parties in a franchising. One party is the buyer of the franchise, who is known as the franchisee, and the other is the company that sells his business concept, who is known as the franchisor. And this franchise comes into existence when there is a formal contract between the franchisee and the franchisor. Then only a franchise will come into existence. And what entails in this agreement, what is containing in this agreements, whereby the franchisor or the company that sells the rights to its business concept grants or allows the buyer of rights or the franchisee. What it allows the buyer? The rights to engage in selling or distributing its products or services. So it will allow the franchisee to engage in selling or distributing the products or services of the franchisor under a prescribed business format. So there will be a prescribed business format under which the franchisee has to operate. So the franchisor gives the rights of selling or distributing the product and services of a franchisor, okay, under a prescribed business format. And finally, for what? In exchange for royalties or share of profits. So this agreement is entered. So in exchange for royalties or share of profits, this rights is given from the franchisor, by the franchisor to the franchisee. So this is the definition, understanding of the definition which was given by David D. Setz. Now if we move forward, it is, when we say franchising, it is a contractual agreement. As we have understood, it is a contract between both parties, therefore it is a contractual agreement between whom? The franchisor, means the manufacturer, wholesaler or service provider, and the franchisee or franchisees. It may be a single franchisee or it may be multiple franchises, which allows the latter to conduct a certain form of business, which allows the franchisee, later means the franchisee, to allow to conduct a certain form of business under a established name according to a specific set of rules, according to the established name or trademark of the franchisor, and as per the specific set of rules that is given by the franchisor. So this is where, in which a contractual agreement is entered, whereby the franchisor gives the rights of selling or distributing the goods to the franchisee, and he operates under certain rules and regulations of the franchisor in order to accomplish the franchising. So next we will understand, the franchise agreements gives the franchisor much discretion in controlling the operations of the franchisor. So even though there is a contractual agreement, since the franchisee is given the rights to sell or distribute the products and service of the franchisor has the discretion, much discretion, is according to his wishes, according to his rules, in controlling the operations of the franchisee. The operations of the franchisee, the way in which the franchisee operates, will be controlled by the franchisor. In why and how this is operations controlling is done, this is in exchange for any royalties or share of profits. The franchisor offers assistance and very often supplies as well. The franchisee will give royalties or share of profits to the franchisee, and the franchisor may offer assistance in marketing, in advertising, in selling, in inventory, in managing the operations of the franchise outlet, and also sometimes, very often, supplies as well. Sometimes supplies of raw materials will be also done by the franchisor. A franchisee has to agree to follow conditions set by the franchisor. It is very important that the franchisee has to agree that he will follow, he or she will follow the condition that is set forth by the franchisor. The conditions may vary from business to business. So various businesses, they may undertake this franchising, and according to the business to business, the conduct, code of conduct, how they operate, the operating procedures will be different, and the rules and regulations will be different. The classic examples of franchising in India are McDonald's, Pizza Hut, Van Heusen, Louis Philippe. These are some of the classic examples where franchising is generally undertaken. So we can say that franchising, if we can put simply, is defined as a form of contractual agreement in which the franchisee enters into an agreement with the franchisor to sell the products or goods of the franchisor under a set rules and regulations set forth by the franchisor in exchange for a specified fee, royalty or share of profits. So in simply we'll put it, franchising is where a success business format is replicated by the franchisee. So in franchising, the is a format in which a successful business format of the franchisor is replicated or imitated by the franchisee. The franchisee agreements give the franchisor, as we have understood, discretion and control over the operations of the franchisee. And this franchisee, they operate by giving certain royalties or share of profits. And this share of profits is given in order to get some assistance and sometimes supplies as well. Okay. The conditions of this franchising will differ from company to company, industry to industry. This is also we have understood. And if we look, if we say what is the assistance that is given by the franchisor to the franchisee, if we try to elaborate on that, we can say that facilities like selection, location selection, training of the staff, management of the staff, marketing, financial financing or giving financial information or managing the finance, promotions, advertisement and promotions, record keeping, etc. These all things are generally, this kind of assistance is given by the franchisor to the franchisee. In addition to that, they also decide the standard operating procedures, SOPs and the trade name of the business under which the franchisee will operate. Okay, a franchisee has to follow all these rules and regulations. If the franchisee do not follow these rules and regulations, it will be problematic. So all the rules and regulations or conditions set by the franchisor is to be followed by the franchisee. The franchisee business exists for various products nowadays. You can say like automobile and parts, softed companies use it, dry cleaning companies use it, business services, this food company, food and beverage company uses, and some classical examples if you say where this franchising is used in India is McDonald's, Pizza Hut, Van Heusen and Louis Philippe. But franchisee has certain advantages and disadvantages. Advantages is that when you open and opt for a franchise, there is a less capital investment, initial less capital investment is required because the business is already set up by the franchisor. And also since the business is already set by the franchisor, there is already certain increased brand awareness about the product or service. So you need not worry about the brand awareness. It is already there. And finally, the product or service is already tested for operation. This the whether the it is a hit or not, whether people like it or not, this is already tested because it's an established successful business format of the franchise. So the operation setting, the way in which it will operate, how to manage this, how to undertake the advertisement promotions, all these things are already set. And also this franchise gives the franchisee an exclusive right to sell the product and services in the particular area. No other person can open a shop and using that trademark. So these are all the advantages of having a franchise retail outlet. But there are certain disadvantages also which cannot be overlooked. First is the oversaturation in some areas. In some areas, there must be too much franchise outlets which may eat into the profit of the franchisee. Sometimes these contract provisions which are set by the franchisor are very strict. That doesn't give any room of any breathing space or room for improvement of the franchisee by the franchisee. Also, sometimes the franchisor deliberately or finds ways of cancelling this agreement that they have entered into or renew the agreement or make changes in the agreement within a short duration of time. And finally, the royalties and the share of profit that has been given by the franchisee to the franchisor eats away a lot of the profit margin from the franchisee. And finally, they have to, the franchisee have to pay for renewal fees from 3 to 5 years, or sometimes lifetime recurring renewal fees and royalties has to be given. So these are certain disadvantages. The advantages, disadvantages will be explained later in detail. But now we will understand that what is franchising. Franchising is a contractual agreement between a franchisor and the franchisee, under which the franchisor gives an exclusive right to the franchisee to sell his product or services, or distribute his product or services under certain guidelines, certain rules and regulations set by the franchisor, in exchange for assistance royalties or share of profits. And the franchisor also promises to provide certain assistance and also sometimes supplies raw materials to the franchisee. So these are the general explanation of what franchising means. Now we'll understand what are the various characteristics of franchising. Now if we look at the characteristics of franchising, since we have understood the definition of franchising, the characteristics are nothing but the various headings that is being included in the definition. Just we will understand in brief what are the various characteristics of franchising. The first characteristic of franchising, it is an agreement to sell product or services of some owner, paying him or her specified fee or commission. So it is a contractual agreement under which there is a sell or distribution of products or services, and the owner receives a certain fee or commission. So this is the first characteristics of franchising. Second, it does not give franchisee the ownership of the product or service. It is very important to understand. Here they only give the right to sell or distribute the product. The owner or the trademark is already in the name of the franchisor. The franchisee do not own the product or service. They only sell or distribute the product or service of the franchisor. It is an agreement for a fixed period of time ranging from 3 to 5 years to 35 years or more than that. So the franchisee agreement is for a certain period of time. After that, if you want to continue with the franchise, then you have to opt for a renewal of the agreement, franchise agreement. So this is very important to understand. In franchise, the franchisor allows the franchisee to use the brand name, trademark or service mark, management skills for developing and expanding franchise business. So what happens here? The franchisor gives franchisee what? The brand name of the franchisor, the trademark or the service mark that is used by the franchisor, and also the management skills, how to manage, develop and expand the franchise business. All this assistance is provided by the franchisor to the franchisee. Then it takes place, franchising takes place in case of businesses with a good track record of profitability. So there must be a proper good track record of profitability, because if the business format is not profitable, then nobody will enter into franchising for that particular product or service. So there must be a good track record of profitability of the product or service. Apart from that, the other characteristics are, it applies to business which can be duplicated or replicated. So it is only possible where the whole business format can be easily duplicated or replicated. If it cannot be duplicated or replicated, it requires originality, then the franchising agreement cannot be entered. So it should apply to only those business which can be easily duplicated and replicated. Then it can be terminated before the expiry of franchising period. We have said that the franchising period may be for 3 years or 5 years or 3 years or more than that, but it can be terminated beforehand, the franchising period. When it can be terminated? When the franchisee do not operate as per the standard operating procedures or the business format that is given by the franchisor. The franchisor has the authority to terminate the franchise agreement. So the franchisee must operate under the standard operating procedures and the rules of the franchise rules set by the franchisor. If it does not follow those rules and regulations, then the franchise agreement can be terminated before the expiry of the franchising period. Now, franchise business is based on mutual agreement or contract setting out terms and conditions for franchise. So, as you have said, that this agreement, mutual agreement, contractual agreement. Mutual means both parties are agreeing to it. Contractual means it is based on certain contract where each party has certain obligations to fulfill. So it is both a mutual or an agreement and a contractual agreement between both parties, that is the franchisor and the franchisee. Setting out the franchise agreement will contain what? Setting out the terms and conditions for franchising. What are the rules and regulations under which the franchisee will operate? What are the roles and responsibilities of the franchisee? What are the roles and responsibilities of the franchisor? All these are enumerated and described as per the terms and conditions. So these things are contained in the agreement, which mutually both the parties, the franchisor and the franchisee, agree and sign the agreement. It is a turnkey operation. Turnkey means complete operation, in which franchisor dictates most of the operations, from store hours to the color of the carpet, etc. So what happens is generally a complete package, complete operation procedure, complete package that is given to the franchisee by the franchisor. It dictates or controls everything, from the operation, how the franchise will operate, to what is the timing for which the store hours so which will open, what will be the color of the carpet, the interior, the design, the way the franchise will operate. All these things are controlled by the franchisor, and the franchisee has to accept all these terms and conditions if he wants to continue the franchise outlet. A franchise business is already set up by the franchisor. The initial investment required by the franchisee to enter the business or establish is very relatively low. So this is also one of the characteristics. Here the initial business is set up by the franchisor. So seed capital, other thing is not required. Everything is already set up. The business format is already profitable, already tried and tested. Now the franchisee has to give an initial investment, nominal investment, so that he may enter into contact with the franchisor, and the franchisee will establish or enter with a relatively low amount of money that is required to enter into a franchise. So these are the various characteristics of franchising. So we have understood what is franchising and what are the various characteristics of franchising. Now we'll try to understand what are the various types of franchising. The first type is product or trademark format. So this is the first kind of franchising. This is the earliest type of franchising. This product or trademark format franchising is the earliest type of franchising. Under this, dealers were given the rights to distribute goods for a manufacturer or franchisor. So under this, the dealers or the franchisees were given a particular right to distribute goods for a manufacturer. For this right, the dealer pays a fee to the right to sell the trademarked goods of the producer. So they had to give a royalty or a specified fee or share of profits. It was required to give by the dealer to the producer. Dealer means the franchisee, and the producer means the franchisor. The franchise operates rather autonomously. Here, only the product or the trademark is being given. The right to sell is not given, but the franchisee operates rather autonomously. The franchisor licenses trademark, but does not usually provide franchisees an entire system for running their business. So they only trademark the product, only they franchise they give the product or the trademark. They do not give an entire package or entire system for running their business. Here the franchisee has the autonomous or the individuality of selling the products. Okay, but the products or trademarks are belonging to the franchisor, but they can operate rather autonomously. Sometimes the franchisor license not only distribution but also part of the manufacturing process, like in case of soft drink manufacturers like Coca-Cola franchise, Coca-Cola and Pepsi. So what happens sometimes the in this kind of product or trademark format of franchising, what happens sometimes the franchisor license not only for the selling and distribution, but also manufacturing process. Especially this is followed by soft drink companies like Coca-Cola and Pepsi. What happens? They will give the manufacturing also, they will give license. So the franchisee will operate, not only sell, distribute, also continue with certain manufacturing processes for the franchisor. Okay. So in brief, we can say that this is one of the earliest type of franchising. When we say franchising, we generally mean the most earliest primitive kind of franchising product or trademark franchising. For this, the right, the dealer pays a certain fee to the franchisor or the producer of the goods. The franchise operates rather operatively. There are certain operating rules which are given by the franchisor, but rather than that, what are the store hours for it to open, or certain location, all these things, or how to maintain display or the facilities is generally given. But otherwise, the whole operation is managed by the franchisee rather autonomously. The franchisor license is trademark, but usually does not provide the entire system of operating the business. Okay. And product franchising was used perhaps for the first time by Singer Corporation. So in 1800, Singer Corporation is mentioned, the sewing machine that was made by Singer Company. It was the first corporation in the world to start giving product or trademark franchising. This was initially given by the Singer Corporation in 1800s, and subsequently it became popular with mostly petroleum companies, automobile companies, for example gas stations. Okay. But sometimes not only the license is given for selling or distribution of the goods, but also for manufacturing process. Certain manufacturing processes are also undertaken by the franchisee. The best example will be soft drink companies like Coca-Cola and Pepsi. So this is the one kind of product or trademark format. Another kind of franchising is business format franchising. What is business format franchising? This type of franchising is a recent type of franchising and is the most popular one at present. So it is the most popular one, and this is recently being followed at present. An arrangement under the business format, what happens? This is an arrangement where the franchisor teaches the franchisee the entire business format. Previously, in the previous format, the product and trademark format, the entire business format was not explained by the franchisor to the franchisee by the franchisor. But in business format, an arrangement is made whereby the franchisor teaches the entire way of operating the business to the franchisee. The franchisor offers a detailed plan and procedures on almost every aspect of the business. Almost on every aspect of the business, the marketing, the inventory, the advertising, the human resources, all every aspect of the business, how to do it, assistance is being provided, and procedures is being set by the franchisor, and provides the initial ongoing training and support. Sometimes the initial and ongoing training of the staff is also done under the business format franchising. What happens? The franchisor offers a wide range of services to the franchisees. As we have discussed, it includes marketing, advertising, strategic planning, where to open the shop, and for how much time the shop should be open, what should be the advertisement, what should be the promotion, the training, the production of operation manuals, how to operate, the standard procedures of operating, the standards of quality and control, what should be the quality level that should be maintained, the selling, the inventory, accounting, and also personnel process. All these things are given by the franchisor to the franchisee. So the entire business format is being taught by the franchisor to the franchisee under business format franchising. And the best example of business format franchising is Pizza Hut. So we have understood this is one of the most popular kind of franchising that is available today, and then this is an arrangement whereby a franchisor teaches the franchisee the entire business format, which includes in marketing, advertising, planning, training, production operations, how to what are the standards of operating, quality, everything, accounting, personnel, everything is been generally given by the franchisor to the franchisee. Business format franchising is the most popular type of franchising system, and when one generally refers to as franchising, they generally mean that this is business format franchising. So we have understood in today's class what is franchising, what are the various characteristics of franchising, and what are the various types of franchising, that is product or trademark franchising, and second time this business format franchising. Okay, please go through the video. I'll send you the notes digitally. Please go through that. If you have any doubts regarding the video or the notes, please contact me. No need to panic. Stay at home. We'll continue this subject, this topic in the next class. And finally, thank you for your attention.